Now that you've run the out-of-the-box ARKit template app, it's now time to get some SceneKit practice by drawing some virtual objects. In order to do that, you'll need to specify where to draw them. Since the real world is three-dimensional and augmented reality is overlaid on top of the real world, ARKit also uses a three-dimensional coordinate system. Let's take a closer look. If you've done UI or 2D graphics programming, you're used to the idea of the origin, the point 0, 0 being an arbitrary point, and the X and Y axes being relative to something. For example, in UIKit and just about every other graphic user interface, the arbitrary point for the origin is the top left corner of the screen window or canvas, and the X and Y axes run parallel to the edges of that screen window or canvas, with the X increasing as you go right and the Y increasing as you go up. If you've done game programming or graphics programming using OpenGL or something based on it, say SpriteKit, the origin follows the convention used in math, and it's at the bottom left corner of the screen, window, or canvas, and again the X and Y axes run parallel to the edges of that screen, window, or canvas. In this setup, X still increases as you go right, but this time Y increases as you go up. In three dimensions, there's still a sense of the origin. Don't worry about where the origin is right now, we'll cover that shortly. Just accept that it's there for now. The 3D axis still extends right and left from the origin, with X increasing as you go right. So far, we're still in familiar territory. The 3D Y axis still extends up and down from the origin, with Y increasing as you go up. Once again, this shouldn't be new to you. You've probably guessed that the third dimension is defined by the Z axis. Now, just as the Y axis is perpendicular to the X axis, the z-axis is perpendicular to both the x and y-axes. If you think of the x-axis as defining left and right, and the y-axis as defining up and down, the z-axis defines toward you and away from you, with z increasing as it goes toward you. At this point, you're probably wondering, in the real world, where's the origin in ARKit? Now, Apple being Apple, you can't be blamed if you guess that the arbitrary point for the ARKit origin was set at Apple's headquarters in Cupertino, California, but that's not useful to most users. Instead, Apple took the user-centric approach and decided that the ARKit origin should be at the precise location of the device when the augmented reality session starts up. For both the user and the programmer, this makes a lot of sense. Now that you know where the ARKit origin is, you're now probably wondering, where's the x-axis, or which way is left or right? Where's the y-axis, or what cut counts as up and down? And finally, what about the z-axis? How do we know what's forwards and backwards? The answers to these questions all depend on which way the x, y, and z-axes point, and that's determined by the alignment setting. ARKit gives you the option to choose from three different ways to determine which way is left, right, up, down, backwards, and forwards. Each way has its uses. We'll use two of them in this course. The first one is called gravity alignment. In all ARKit alignment settings, including gravity, the origin is where the device is at the start of the ARKit session. The x-axis is defined by the position of the left and right sides of the device at the start of the ARKit session, with X increasing as you go right and decreasing as you go left. The Y-axis is defined by the force of gravity, with Y increasing as you move upward or away from the Earth, and decreasing as you move downward or towards the Earth. And finally, the Z-axis is defined by the position of the front and back of the device at the start of the ARKit session, with Z increasing as you move towards the front of the phone or towards the user, and decreasing as you go towards the back of the phone or away from the user. You should use this alignment in AR apps where you only care about the position and orientation of the device relative to its position and orientation at the start of the AR session. This is the alignment that you'll use in the first two ARKit apps that you'll build. There's another alignment, one that takes both gravity and compass heading into account, and you'll use it later on in this course. As you saw when you ran the ARKit template app, ARKit can draw complex 3D shapes covered with graphic textures, such as the spaceship. ARKit can also draw simple geometric shapes, things like cubes, spheres, cones, cylinders, and so on. In SceneKit, they're called geometries. You're going to use them to get familiar with adding objects into an augmented reality scene. So, how do you add objects to a SceneKit augmented reality scene? By adding them to the SceneKit graph. It's a tree structure of nodes where anything in the scene is either a child of the root node or a child of one of those children. An empty SceneKit scene is one with no children. You add an object to an empty SceneKit scene by adding it as a child of the root node. Then you can add more nodes, either as children of the root node or children of any other node in the scene. And finally, any object can run an action. That's something that can be used to change its position, orientation, appearance, or other properties. Well, that's enough lecturing for now. Let's get back to coding.
Augmented reality is a fascinating technology that allows us to mix a little bit of the virtual world with the real world. Of course, there's a lot more to it than that, so subscribe to this channel and tap that notification bell to be alerted when new videos on AR are released.